Now you create wrestling fans. I have longtime independent wrestling fan Robert. Get rich or die trying was my first time seeing Now You Create live, and oh man, what an awesome show this turned out to be. The show began with Larry Legend in the ring introducing Julius Smokes, and Smokes mentioned some of the names on the show and wanted to get to for crowd reactions, and forgot what else he ended up saying, but the action got underway with the first of two NYC initiative matches as the Sky Reaper, is it? Casey Navarro defeated the one MV Young. Both of these men were very impressive, and I was shocked that Young, as soon as Larry Legend got through with the introductions, he attacked Navarro right away. But these two guys put on a great match, and hopefully they'll both be back and Now You Create in the future. Up next, it was time for the Jurassic Juggernaut Vince Steele's Open Challenge, which was answered by not one, not two, not three, but four men, which saw the Jurassic Juggernaut defeat J.J. Adams, the Latin Stallion, Brother Greatness, and Claw. After the match had ended, Steele, by the way, Steele pinned Latin Stallion with the hangover leg drop from the top rope that Booker T was known for. Steele pressed Brother Greatness over his head, got a running start, and threw him like a human javelin towards the pillar of the building in Darrow's gym. And I believe he also gave J.J. Adams a spine buster. I don't know if that was after the match or not, but I know after the match he did throw Greatness into that pillar before Steele took his leave from the ring. Next up, out comes Felicia Rose, and she introduces the unpredictable Jay George, who came to the ring singing Rick Astley's Never Gonna Give You Up. And Jay George complaining that Pinky Sanchez came out to his music at the last Now You Create show back in April. And Jay George issued an open challenge, and he said, oh, Pinky's not going to come out, but Pinky Sanchez does come out, and the match is on. And eventually, I think Sanchez had Jay George in the figure four leg lock, but in comes Felicia Rose, and she takes the referee and rubs his face in her breasts. Pinky eventually gets a hold of Felicia. He goes to put her in the figure four leg lock. And then Jay George got like a running kick to Sanchez's face, and Jay George pinned Sanchez while he still had the figure four on Felicia Rose. So the unpredictable Jay George got the victory. Next up in a great four-way matchup, we saw the Caveman defeat the Grim Reaper, Max Stardom, and the Black G's, who was accompanied the ring by Julius Smokes. Next up was a three-way tag team match, as we saw UFA? UFA Kings, which is Sean Maluta and Afa Jr., as they defeated the representing the GOAT, Chris Cage and Superstar Whiplash, who were accompanied ring by Ivy Roman, and the team of Steve Pena and Astro Morales. UFA, UFA. That's right, Afa and Maluta's tag team name is. Next up was the second NYC initiative of the night, as the strategist Jess Neff defeated Nutrius X, the Brooklyn Outlaw Mike Donovan, Nutrius X, and Nikos Rikos in a great matchup. hopefully Nutrius X will be in Now You Create more often, as well as Mike Donovan and Chris Rex in the future. Then what was originally going to be a tag team match wound up a six-man tag, as outcomes representing Creator Die, the King of New York, EC Negro, The Body, Steve Lugo, and the Wave God, is it? Sebastian Cage, accompanied to the ring by Miguel. And their scheduled opponents are Homicide and Dan Moff. And I understand it was going to be no disqualification, but Homicide and Moff announced that they have a partner, and it was representing the GOAT, Reyes. And the match was on, and Julius Smokes was out there with Homicide and Moff. Eventually, Smokes took his belt off, and he was whipping, whether it was Cage, Lugo, Negro, Al, even whipped Miguel a few times when they got close to each other. Eventually, TJ Marconi, who did not wrestle on this show, he comes out. He goes after Homicide. He goes after Homicide. Eventually, Monster Mac, he somehow, in the chaos, hits the ring, scoops up Dan Moff, and hits him with a sit-down pile driver, which the late Bam Bam Bigelow called Greetings from Asbury Park. Mac then place Sebastian on top of Moff for the three count. Mac then throws Cage to the outside, and at that point, yeah, Mac stands Moff up, hits him with a stiff lariat, or as he called it, the clothesline from Compton. Mac asks for the microphone. He's about to speak, but then drops the microphone and leaves the ring. And then in the final match of the show, we see Cheeseburger go one-on-one with Hot Dog Starks. And eventually something happened. Somebody knocked one of the referees down. Out comes another referee dressed as a bottle of ketchup. And I forgot, somebody eventually knocked him down. Out comes another referee dressed up as a bottle of mustard. He eventually gets knocked down, and the original referee eventually gets up in what was a great matchup. And in this matchup, Hot Dog Starks really got to showcase what he can do in that ring. Cheeseburger defeated Hot Dog Starks in what turned out to be a great way to end the show. Jurassic Juggernaut Vince Steel comes out and he attacks Starks. Cheeseburger comes back to the ring, attempts to stop him, but Steel knocks Cheeseburger, or should I say, he tried to turn him into mincemeat. But then Reyes of the GOAT hits the ring, and the monsters were face to face, prompting a holy shit chant from the crowd. And the monsters did butt heads, and Reyes cleared the ring of Steel, and Reyes dared Steel to come back in the ring, but the referee wouldn't let Steel go back in. Oh, one thing I forgot to mention, among Vince Steel's opponents, the Latin Stallion. I haven't seen that guy wrestle. I've seen that guy since I saw him in USA Pro Wrestling back in the early to mid 2000s. This show, I guess time for the personal notes, I should say. Great seeing Susie, Jacqueline, Yasmin, Charmaine, Stella, Jennifer. I didn't catch her husband Omar. Melanie, Karen, Bill Parham, Jason, Charmaine. Not sure if I left anybody out that I saw at the show. There was no intermission for this particular event. Maybe it's a good thing, because after the show I was so hungry. I stopped at Sabbath's Chicken on Westchester Avenue, right underneath Elder Avenue train station. They've got some great food over there. And unless I'm mistaken, I think I may have seen Ivy Roman of the GOAT leaving as I was waiting for my food. During the three-way tag team match, I don't know whose bright idea it was to play John Cena's entrance music. I guess that's your typical, that was the WTF moment of the show. We have one memorable quote. I'll give you pow-pow, Miguel to Julius Smokes during the six-man tag when Miguel, I think, took his belt off or got his hands on a strap of his own. Now you create wrestling clearly, obviously, has itself a two-club. Wonder why TJ Marconi did not wrestle. He was going to team with AC Negro to face Homicide and Dan Moff in a tag match. Because I guess maybe that was, if maybe he was unable to wrestle, and maybe that was the reason for some of the changes in the original lineup. I want to say right now, now you create. I sure hope when football season gets underway, I hope you do not run shows on Sundays. I mean, I hope you're doing great since I finally saw the product for the first time. I sure hope you don't run shows on Sundays during football season. And while I'm on the subject of future shows, Now You Create returns with Protect Your Neck on Friday, August 10th. Location has not been announced yet. I don't know if it's going to even be at Darrow's Gym in the Bronx, New York. Matches have not been announced yet, but I would like to see a return match between Pinky Sanchez and the unpredictable Jay George. I'd like to see... Let me see what else I'd like to see. I'd like to see maybe Vince Steele go one-on-one with Reyes. I'd like to see if Damoff and Monster Mac do not go one-on-one. I'd like to see Homicide one-on-one with TJ Marconi. I'd like to see Damoff one-on-one with the King of New York, EC Negro. Dang it. Oh, boy. Okay, I think that'll pretty much do it. Was a very good show, by the way, and definitely... Well, actually, before I went out the door, Julius Smokes noticed me, and he said, thank you for coming. I don't know if he remembered me as the guy in the front row, and... One whale of a show this was, and all the best for Now You Create, and I really think this promotion will really get bigger and bigger as the time goes on.